Senator Lynn. I knew I was late coming to sign off because I was sleeping. But I hadn't got a wink of sleep last night. First, that lady from downstairs, who is Gaga, is the representative of stacking cell, Mr. Tesco. Her cat was scratching at my door. I shouted at the door, but it just wouldn't. It went on and on, scratching and mooning. And so finally, I'd had just about all I could take. I said to her, "Look, little cat, if you don't lay off scratching at my door, I'm going to lose my temper with you, and then there's no telling what I'll do." This cat stared at me, right in my eye, as if it was thinking about canceling me back. But then what better of it? I went prowling off down the corridor. I got back into bed and started to count Frank Sinatra songs with the word love in the title. And just as I got to drifting off, there's them next door, rowing again. And then it's not that loud. It's not like I couldn't put the radio on to cover it up. But it's not the sound you see. It's the knowing. The knowing that right in the next building, there's this couple tearing each other's heart to pieces. The sound I could handle, but the tragedy. I decide to say a prayer for them, that whatever is troubling and tormenting them will be fixed soon. And I give you the next 24 hours. I know that I'll go another night of crashing and dying next door. But try as I might, I can't even concentrate on praying because. Because the scratching starts again. I open the door and I say to her, "Look, little cat, you best lay off scratching at my door, or I'm going to go downstairs and get your mother and tell her how naughty you'll be." And I don't think you'd like to walk around at this time of night, do you? And this cat stares at me, right in my eye. She lays up her claw and lashes out right across my shin, and I kick out. I kick out and send her flying. You know how cats are meant to land on their feet, right? She doesn't. She just sort of hits the wall and slides down it. And I'm not normally like that, you see. I am normally the most pleasant person you'd ever hope to meet. Also, my mother said, but the doctor did say I might give it short-tempered for a while. I go over to her. She's breathing, but she isn't moving. "You best go home now, little cat," I tell her. But the blue thing just wouldn't move. So I pick her up and I put her on a cushion. And I take her back into her flat. And I put her little soft lip next to her. But even that doesn't spark any interest. So I go back to bed. But I still can't get any sleep because the cat is making this sound like it's gargling TCP, and it's giving me the creeps. So about 5 o'clock in the morning, I finally got off to sleep. And then suddenly I was staring at your chest. Only I wasn't. I just really wanted to know your name, and you'd put your badge on your chest. So what else was I supposed to look? Best wishes, Mathew.